Dear friends, welcome to another Arduino tutorial. Today we are going to learn how to use Bluetooth to exchange data between two Arduino ports. As a demonstration project, we are going to build a simple weather station. There is a lot to cover, so let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects. In this channel, I share everything about the projects I built to help you develop similar projects or inspire you to start making things because it is easy, fun and creative. Subscribe to the channel now if you don't want to miss any future video. Today's project is this. An Arduino Nano is measuring the temperature and the humidity using the DHT22 sensor. This board sends the data from the sensor to another Arduino Nano board, which displays the data from the sensor on a small screen and sends back a message that the data was received okay. When the first Arduino board receives the okay message, the LED lights up. As you can see, we have established a bi-directional communication channel, and the two Arduino boards can exchange data. To achieve that, we use a low-cost Bluetooth module, the HC05. The range we can achieve is excellent. We can easily get about 10 meters of range even with walls between the modules. It is a perfect solution for indoor use and very easy to implement. Let's now see how to build this project. The parts needed for today's project are the following: two Arduino Nanos, two HC05 Bluetooth modules, a DHT22 sensor, a 1.8-inch color TFT display, two breadboards, two 1K resistors, two 2K resistors, and some wires. The total cost of the project is around $20. You can find links to all the parts I use in the description of the video below. The HC05 Bluetooth module is a very low-cost Bluetooth module for Arduino. It costs around $3. If you haven't used a Bluetooth module with Arduino in the past, please watch a detailed tutorial I have prepared about it by clicking on this card. It will help you a lot. We are going to use two modules in this project, so one of them must be set in master mode and the other one to slave mode to achieve bi-directional communication. That's what we are going to do now. First of all, we have to connect the module to an Arduino. We need to connect 5 wires. Please follow this schematic diagram. The RX and TX pins of the module use 3.3V logic levels, so we use a simple voltage divider at the RX pin of the module and we do not connect it directly to the Arduino port. Also note that the RX pin of the module goes to the RX pin of the Arduino and the TX pin of the module goes to the TX pin of the Arduino. Now we are ready to power up the Arduino. Before plugging in the USB cable, press the button on the Bluetooth module to enter the command mode. If the LEDs on the module start flashing slowly, that means that we have entered the command mode successfully. Now all we have to do is to upload an empty sketch to the Arduino port. Before pressing upload, remove the wires from the serial port of the Arduino board and connect them again after the sketch has been uploaded. The next step is to open the serial monitor and send some commands to the Bluetooth module. We select both new line and carriage return here and we set the baud rate at 34,800. Now we can send commands to the module. First, let's send the command AT to see if we can communicate with the module. The module returns OK. Then we send the command AT plus UART question mark to see the default baud rate. As you can see, it is set to 9,600. Then we send the command AT plus roll question mark to find out if the module is in master or slave mode. The module returns 0, which means that the module is set at slave mode. Since we need to configure the slave module first, we won't change the mode of this module. If you need to change the mode of the module, send the following command: AT plus roll equal 0 if you want the module to be in slave mode, or AT plus roll equals 1 if you want the module to be in master mode. Next, we need to find its address. We send the command AT plus ADDR question mark and we get back the address of the module. We need this value later, so note it down. The slave Bluetooth module is ready. Let's now configure the master. We follow the same procedure. We send the command AT to see if we can communicate correctly. We find the default baud rate of the module, which is 9600. The baud rate must be the same for both modules. If the baud rate of your module is not set to 9600, you can set it to that speed with the command AT plus UART equals 9600,0,0. Now we set the module to master mode with the command AT plus roll equals 1. Then we send the command AT plus C mode equals 0, which means that the module will connect to a fixed address. The last step is to send the command AT plus bind equals followed by the address of the slave module. Note that we write the address like this. We are using commas instead of colons. That's it. If we power up the modules once more, after a few seconds, they will pair automatically and the LEDs will start flashing every 2 seconds. We can now quickly send data from one module to the other. It is as easy as writing to the serial. Let's now connect a sensor and a display to build a useful project. This is the schematic diagram of the circuit which uses the slave Bluetooth module. You can find links to all the schematic diagrams of the project in a link in the description of the video. We have connected a DHT22 temperature sensor and an LED. Every 2 seconds we read the values from the sensor and we send them to the other Bluetooth module. If the data is received from the other part, the LED lights up. The code is straightforward for an advanced project like this one. I am using the Easy Transfer library to make things easier. This library enables us to send data structures to the serial port, which means we can send structured data via the Bluetooth module. So, I have created a very simple data structure which contains 2 float variables, the temperature and the humidity we read from the sensor. We save the readings from the sensor to the variables and then we send the structure to the Bluetooth module with the command etout.senddata. We can also read the data structure that the other Bluetooth module sends with the command receiveData. Note that we need 2 easy transfer objects to achieve bi-directional communication. One object is responsible for sending data and the other to receive data. Let's now take a quick look at the circuit which uses the master Bluetooth module. I have connected a small screen to it to display the data we are receiving from the other circuit. As you can see, the information on the display is updated every 2 seconds. When we receive the data, we send back a message to the other module that the data was received. As you can see, the code is very simple as well. We use the same data structures and the same logic. We receive weather data with the command etin receive data and we send out an acknowledgement message with the command etout send data. As always, you can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video below. After building this simple project, we can see that by using the Bluetooth protocol, we can easily achieve a reliable bidirectional connection between 2 Arduinos. The range is very good. It reaches 10 meters. The power consumption is low because the Bluetooth protocol is designed for low power consumption. In my opinion, it is the easiest and more reliable communication protocol for indoor use. We just need to connect 2 wires and we are ready to send or receive data. Amazing stuff. I am going to use the Bluetooth technology a lot in future projects. The first project that I have in mind is to build a Bluetooth remote control for this tank robot I created a few weeks ago. It is going to be a fascinating project. I would love to hear your opinion about today's projects. Do you find it useful and are you going to build any projects using 2 Bluetooth modules? Please post your ideas in the comment section below. I love reading your ideas. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects twice a month. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. I will see you in the next video.